Hi everyone, and welcome to the next video tutorial, which will be focusing on how to create a Django admin honeypot. Okay, so basically we're going to make use of the Django admin honeypot package. Now we're going to be using the updated version, and the reason for this is because for those of you that are making use of Django 4.0, this will work nicely for you. So I just want to accommodate all of you as well. Okay, so to give you a bit more detail here, as we can see here, so this package is basically going to allow us to create a fake Django admin login screen, okay, that's going to notify our administrators of any sort of attempted unauthorized access, okay. So basically, we're going to create a honeypot or sort of a trap for anyone that tries to access our login page on our Django web application. Okay, so before we can install this package and go with the details, there are a few things we just need to understand and wrap our heads around. So first of all, I just want to explain a few things. So I just have a normal Hello World application running, very simple, very straightforward. So if I were to head over to my main project, so my project is called Elevate, and here I'm within Elevate URLs, and we can see we have a admin page here. So this is the default admin page that we get with every basic Django web application once we set it up. And we can reach that admin page by just putting in /admin. And there we are. Okay. Now this is actually very dangerous, okay? I would not suggest having your actual administration page or admin page in Django just with /admin. I would recommend that you at least change the route here. Okay, so what I would recommend you do is to change the route here. So I'm going to change it to something different. So I'm going to call this Inluchtung, okay? So it's a bit of a different language there, but you can go ahead and change the route to anything you want. Okay, and the great thing now is if we go to admin, okay, that's not going to be found. We only have Inluchtung. So of course, that would be our admin page. Okay, so this provides us a safe way to make sure that no one accesses our main Django admin page. Of course, you do need to, of course, also remember to, in the end, set debug to false, so no one can see your debug configuration settings, such as your URLs, your views, etc. So make sure you also set this to false. The only reason I'm not setting it to false now is because I don't want to lose the styling and format of this Django form here, as you can see. So that is the reason for that. But I would strongly recommend to secure your admin page. Make sure you change the route. Don't keep it as admin. So that's the first thing that we need to just understand before we move into further detail. So when we at it, what I want you to do is to head into your projects directory, and I want you to create a super user. So I'm going to say python manage.py create super user. Okay, and I'm just going to call this person admin2. Leave the email blank. I'm going to enter in a password. Okay. And there we go. Just be sure to turn on your server again. Okay, so get that on. There we go. Okay, so let's just refresh. And you can just put in your admin credentials. So I'm just going to put that in. Okay, so that's working fine. Okay, so I just wanted to get the basics here all set and ready before we actually move on to making use of a honeypot. So I'm just going to head over back to my default page. All right, so head on back here. Right, so let's actually go ahead and create our fake admin login page. So what we can do is install this package here. Okay, so you want to head over to your terminal. So make sure you're in your CMD accordingly, and you can just go ahead and install the following. So we can just go ahead and copy this here, and we can just paste in as you see. Okay, so we can just go ahead and install that package. Okay, so let's just wait for this. There we go. Okay, so it's installed. Great. Right, so we might as well go ahead and actually, we don't need to turn our server online. Actually, you can go ahead and do it if you wish. We don't actually need to do that just yet. Right, so we've got that all set. Now we can scroll down and just read the documentation here. So what we need here, of course, is we need our actual admin page URL, which is denoted by secret in this case, but in my case, I called mine Inluchtung. You can call yours anything that you want. And then we're going to have the admin honeypot URL. Okay, so what we can do, it's very simple. We can just copy over this line here, okay? And this is going to be our honeypot. And we're going to set that route to admin. So anyone that tries to access our Django application via admin, we are going to track all those users and store all of their data within our actual, within our actual admin page. So first of all, let's copy this over here, this URL. This is admin. We can paste it here. And you can just remove that namespace. We don't need that namespace. Okay, make sure you have this. Okay, so as we can see here, our route is now admin. Okay, and we are making use of the admin honeypot URL. Okay, now just to make it clear, I'm going to add a comment here that says admin page honeypot. Okay, and this is going to be our actual admin page. So our actual admin page is called Inluchtung, which is here. Okay, so we've got that all set and ready to go. So the next thing that we can do is head over to our settings.py. Okay, and what we can do here is just add in the under installed apps our actual honeypot. So we just want to add that in accordingly. So the app is going to be called admin underscore honeypot, and just remember to add in your comma. All right, so what you want to do now is you can just say python manage.py make migrations. Okay, so just make sure there aren't any migrations. All right, there we go, we got a migration change there. And then python manage.py migrate. Okay, so there we go, it's applied the migration, great. Now what we can do is go ahead and run our server. And I'm going to show you exactly what's going on now. Let's run that, and there we go. So let's say that we want to access our admin page. So we can see here we have our admin route here. So let's say we want to access that. So I'm going to go say admin. So I'm going to refresh a bit. I'm going to go back, and I'm going to go back to admin. So I want to build up a bit of a history, you could say, of going into the login page. And I want to also go ahead and add in my actual admin details that we created earlier on here. So you can go ahead and enter in your admin details here. And once you've added that in, try to actually log in. And it's going to show failed. Great. So we are now pretending that we are hacking or trying to make use of someone's username and password on the fake honeypot, which we just created. And the good thing about this honeypot, it's now going to log all those attempts that I made to access the admin page and to actually log into it, into our actual admin page, okay, which is denoted here as secret, but I called mine Inluchtung, and this is my actual admin page. So if we were to head over there, so I'm going to put mine in, and I'm going to add in my username and password. So I'm going to add that in. Let me add that in accordingly. Okay, you're going to now see that we installed that admin honeypot app, okay, and it created a model for us called login attempts. Okay, so you can click on login attempts, and it's going to show us, okay, we can see here, for example, someone tried to log in with the username admin2 from this IP address. That was the time that it happened, and that was the URL that they tried to access. So this is very helpful if you want to protect your admin page and you want to track anyone that's trying to do anything malicious by taking a chance to access your Django admin page by /admin. So you can see this is particularly helpful to, you know, ensure protection of your admin page and know, you know, and to also know if you have any issues that you need to figure out, any security gaps, thinking, and this can be a very helpful reminder to say, to the least, to make sure that perhaps you have two-factor authentication on your admin page, because if you have a lot of people trying to access your admin page and on this honeypot that we made use of, that might, you know, kind of worry you, not in a bad way, but in a good way, to give you the realization as in, look, okay, people are actually trying to gain access to my admin page. What can I do to actually protect my real admin page, which in this case is called Inluchtung in my case? Okay, so this is a very helpful tool. So I'll definitely recommend making use of this package here. I will be sure to add this link in the description. So I'll add it as the first link for you. So I'll definitely recommend to make use of this Django admin honeypot to ensure that we can track any login attempts. Now, a really good thing is you can actually go further with this package, and you can also use it to notify admins. So you can notify yourself with an email for someone that tried to gain access to your Django application via the route admin forward slash. So this is particularly important if the person has a basic knowledge of Django, and perhaps they have some idea to think that you're using Django, and they try and take a chance to log into your page, and it's very important for you to know about it to ensure that you follow strict security measures. Okay, so that's it, guys. How to create a honeypot right in front of your Django admin page and to track any sort of unauthorized users trying to gain access to your application. All right, guys, so that's it, and I hope you liked the video, and as always, thank you for the support.